Hi, I'm Larry Fricks. I'm director of the Appalachia Consulting Group and vice president of peer services for the Depression and Bipolar Support Alliance. We have 1,000 chapters across all 50 states. I want to talk a little bit about my own recovery story. Peers were critical to me getting back a life. The first example of a peer making a huge difference in my recovery was on my third hospitalization. I'd had a very dramatic manic experience, and no one could reach me. And on my third hospitalization, it was another peer who I bonded with and I came to trust, and he suggested that it might help me to try lithium. No one else, my family, the doctors, no one else could convince me that I should try to take medication. The medication helped. But after the situation of my symptoms getting better, I became utterly hopeless, very suicidal. And once again, it was a peer who came to my rescue. I went to a meeting of people in recovery from bipolar illness and depression. I saw people that had careers, that had partners, that had hope. And so in my own lived experience of recovery, on two occasions, peers literally made the difference in me believing that I could have a life in the community and that I could recover. And that's one of the reasons I'm so excited about the work in Michigan. Michigan, more than any other state in the country, has made an absolute commitment to the peer workforce. They understand that to change a system, it has to change from focusing on our illness and disability to focusing on our strengths. They have in place the infrastructure to be able to bill for peer services in such a way that the peers can do what they do best. And that's helping people realize they can recover, helping people get a life in the community, help them with housing, help them with employment, and most of all, just believing that once again they can have a meaningful life and have friends and truly experience what we would call a life in the community. In fact, because of Michigan's leadership nationally on whole health, they were chosen to be part of a study being done by the Benson Henry Institute for Mind-Body Medicine at Massachusetts General Hospital. The founder of that, Dr. Herbert Benson, is a Harvard cardiologist and is the foremost researcher on what stress does to your body. And we are a population of people under huge stress. In fact, stress is a major contributor to our early death. And so when Michigan stepped up and agreed to be part of a study of introducing consumers to the relaxation response made famous by Dr. Herbert Benson, they have taken a lead in demonstrating that whole health is the future. And we're looking forward to the research and the data coming out of that study. But we already know that it's changing lives. And as people learn to manage stress, they also learn to live a life where they're more involved with day-to-day direction of recovery. One of the most frightening things that happened for me this year, frightening but exciting, was to be part of a book that came out in January and went to number 10 on the New York Times bestseller list. The book is called Strong at the Broken Places. And it's about five people, and all of us have become strong after going through life situations that often break people. I'm the only one in the book that represents someone in recovery from a mental illness. And I was honored to be asked to be part of the book because we have to be part of the whole community. That book resulted in a Today Show production, and for 5 days, the Today Show followed me around the country, And you're going to be seeing some of that clip as part of this recovery website. And so nothing is more concrete change than investing in a group of people who were once segregated, often died in state hospitals, buried on the grounds of cemeteries, now being asked to change the system. And that request is no stronger than in Michigan. What we are doing is saying that we value your lived experience of recovery. We value the strengths that you use to recover. And with some skills that we can train you to do, you are keeping people out of hospitals. You're saving taxpayer dollars. You're living the dream of many people in the system that came to work in mental health believing that people could get a meaningful life in the community. It has been a great honor to be part of that movement, and in particular, to be in a state like Michigan that's leading the country in investing in a peer workforce for system transformation.